Distributed element circuits are often used above 1 GHz. In such circuits, the capacitance and inductance of these circuits is determined by the shape and location of different copper elements in the PCB layout, rather than being concentrated at one point in space. Entire circuit blocks, such as filters and amplifiers, can be created from such distributed components. To obtain the desired characteristics, such elements require calculation and modeling in special software. Once the geometry of these elements is determined, it can be saved in a DWG or DXF file format. Altium Designer allows you to import DWG and DXF files into a PCB layout or footprint so that these circuits can be placed in your circuit board. For example, let's create a footprint for a low-pass filter. When importing from a DXF, you need to select the measurement units, set the width of the lines, and select the layer to which we want to import the contour. After you click OK, the geometry will be imported from the DXF file. We can move the imported contour freely using the Move commands from the Edit menu. To create a topology from the contour, activate the top layer, and then select the contour. Run the Tools Convert Create Region from Selected Primitives command. The selected path can now be deleted. This creates the filter geometry on the top layer using a region primitive. If necessary, set the mask expansion value in the Properties panel. To ensure there is a connection between the footprint and symbol, and later to nets on the PCB, we will place pads numbered 1 and 2 at the input and output of the filter. Now we can save this data in a library. The pads in the footprint are short-circuited with copper. Therefore, when creating a symbol, you need to change the symbol type to net tie. Now, let's select the footprint and save the library. We can now place a filter in the schematic sheet. Let's do this from the symbol library using the Place button. On the schematic, create the necessary connections and add a filter designator number using the Annotate Schematic Quietly command. In our case, the PCB already has connectors, so we can run the Update PCB Document command to update the filter and its net connections. The filter is now placed as a regular component. First, let's place the filter in the location we need. You can see that the filter pads have different nets, although they are connected by one copper region. In this case, a short circuit violation does not occur since we have selected the net tie component type. However, to create a connection to such a component while routing, you must select the Ignore Obstacles mode. Now we add the tracks and, if necessary, open the solder mask by setting the required opening in the Properties panel. We have now created a board with our distributed element filter, the topology of which was stored in a third-party CAD file and imported into Altium Designer.